Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, I'm gonna let you into my mind. I'm gonna share with you how I learn things. Are you ready? If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. So Patrick and I have been doing this for a long time. We put out a lot of videos, we do the live streams. I work with customers in my day to day. And a lot of times people will sometimes comment about, how do you know all of this stuff? How did you figure that out? This is kind of a thing that we've developed over the years. And so I wanted to share that with you. And I will preface this with, there's not a lot of magic here. It's just a lot of work. This also doesn't apply to just a Power BI. You may be coming here because of Power BI, but I've done this approach with everything that I've learned, whether it's my old on-premises software that I used to work with, whether it's video production, how to do a live stream, how YouTube works. So the first thing, just try it. Like, start playing around with things, clicking on buttons, see what happens, publish things. Like with my camera, I hit some buttons, see what they do, and learn about different settings that are there. If you're not familiar with something, explore it. Figure out what it is, what it's like. I've never been afraid of just opening a piece of software or trying something new and just playing around with it and seeing what it does. One of my old colleagues, he used to use what he called the keyboard test. And so he would just open up the piece of software and just bang on the keyboard, all the different buttons all at the same time, clicking on mouse all over the place and seeing what actually happened. You get some interesting error messages, you get some interesting behavior, and you may see things that you normally don't see. And now you may be asking, like, well, how do I know necessarily what to try and or what to go explore? This is where in my day-to-day, we will get questions or we'll see questions out there, and that may trigger you to go try something, right? That's an opportunity to learn and explore. Come up on Twitter, you may see someone's post. You may be watching one of our live streams and you see someone ask a question and you're not sure like what it does. Internally, in my day job, there are questions that come up in a Teams channel. Another area also is if you go to the community site, so community.powerbi.com, there are lots of questions there as well. And if you're not familiar with something, go try it. So enough of all this talking, let's head over to my machine and look at an example of this. So I'm on the community site. I already found one. So page tabs missing on reports. And so you may be going like, well, what does this mean? And they noticed, you know, they have an app published that contains 5 reports. And usually just to the right of the new menu, you know, they show up, there's a list of tabs. Today, all we see are gray boxes. And so what would you do? So here I've gone to Power BI. I'm inside of a workspace and I'm just going to click on create an app. And I get all of these options. Again, I'm just exploring, right? I'm clicking around, seeing what these things do. Some of them are pretty obvious, right? Put in a description here. We can click around. We can see navigation. Oh, what is this about? We can see here, there's a little eyeball there. Well, what does that do? Oh, it hides it. So these are items that I can play around with to understand more. As you're going through and trying things, you may get stuck in a certain area. There may be a specific thing that you may not understand. Sometimes I do go to the documentation. The docs are pretty general based, and so they're just covering a general aspect of a given topic. They're not going through all the intricacies of what specifically you're going to be looking at. Sometimes you get lucky and they do, other times they don't. So let's take a look. So if we go to the actual documentation for publishing an app, you can see here there's this design the navigation experience, or maybe we'll just search, right? So this takes you right into the design the navigation experience, how to work with pages, how to actually do these things. And it just talks about the general options that you have when creating these items. Doesn't go into all of the different combinations of things and what the behaviors will be. Sometimes you'll get a good hint. And what I'm really looking for is the hint. I know how to click around. I know how to kind of make some connections with obvious things, but sometimes I just need a pointer in a direction to get me going and kickstart the journey. All right, so what if you're stuck? You know, you're in something you don't know, the docs aren't helping you. What do? You go to the search engine of your choice, but when you go to Bing, type in your question and see what comes up. And you may have to work with this. Searching is sometimes an art, and it's about the keywords that you use and the things you're specifically asking for. I've had so many times where someone came to me is like, what does this error message mean? I'm like, I have no idea. Let's go search for it. And I actually searched just for that error message to see what comes up. Sometimes nothing, which tells me that this is a pretty obscure error, or sometimes you actually get real details in terms of, you know, others' experiences with those given errors. I remember before the internet, it was even harder to go figure that out because you couldn't just search for it. So today you have a powerful weapon. So take advantage of that. For example, I can go in here and I can just say Power BI, I'm publishing an app and I'm trying to work with pages. And you'll see, you'll get some videos here. Hey, who's that guy? And then you'll see other items here that'll takes me to the documentation. It's also gonna give you some related search words. This may give you a better search option than what you were trying. Sometimes it will, sometimes it won't, but again, it's the hint. Another thing that's key when you're searching is sometimes you won't get exactly what you're looking for, but you may get something related to it. So as you build your knowledge about how things work, you'll be able to make those connections easier. So sometimes I've gone into docs that have nothing to do with the specific thing that I'm looking at, but I know it's related. If you're having a web browser issue, maybe it's related to web browsers, but it's not exactly the issue that you're having. Or maybe it's some authentication error, right? It's not specifically with Azure AD, but it's something else, maybe even in a different product. And it gives you that hint to say, hey, go play with this setting. And then you can connect those dots. The other thing that's fun when you're exploring these items, you'll see error messages. And so when you're talking with someone or you come up with something again in the future, you see that error message in the context of where it happened. You're like, oh, I hit that before. I know exactly what's going on. It's because of this thing. That has helped me so many times. And then the last thing I'm going to give you, I watch a lot of YouTube. A lot of what I learn nowadays, I just search for videos on it. Usually there's videos for those items. Again, whether it's Power BI, video production, trying to figure out best optimizations inside of games. I'm a gamer, so I look for those types of things. These are all things that you can go discover. Fun story with my daughter. She is into drawing. And she asked me one time, she's like, hey, I'm really struggling with how to draw shoes in like an anime style. And I'm like, well, go to YouTube, ask the question. And so if I go to YouTube and I want to search for Power BI, and you're going to get suggestions here that are in there. Or for my daughter, how to draw anime shoes. And you come up with all sorts of things that are just instructions of how to do it. Her mind was blown. She's like, oh my gosh, I can just search for that. And then you can go learn those things and figure out how to do it and understand how those things work and how they relate to each other. All right, hopefully that inspires you a little bit to go learn about something and to see how something works. Let me know down in the comments below what you think. Are there other ways that you learn things, or how do you actually go about learning those items? I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.